we're going to look at the external anatomy of the skull, and we're going to start with just the bones of the cranial case, and we're going to talk about the bones and the bony parts. So this is an anterior view. You know it's anterior because you can see the eyes and the nose and the mouth. And the first bone of the cranial case, the brain cavity, is the frontal bone here. And then I'm going to turn it to a lateral view. And again, you can see the frontal bone and then the parietal bone. And there's going to be two parietal bones, one on the right and one on the left. And then here we have the temporal bone, and you can see the temporal bone here. And there's several parts that we need to know for the temporal bone, one of which is this hole. That's our external auditory or acoustic meatus, so the external auditory meatus. And the bony part just behind it is the mastoid process, and the mastoid process is a structure that is an attachment site for muscles that enables us to move our head. So again, here you have your temporal bone. And then I'm going to turn to a posterior view of the skull, and you can see this occipital bone, the back of the cranial cavity, the occipital bone. So here's the occipital bone, and we're just going to keep rotating around. So we're on the other side, and again, here you have your parietal bone and your temporal bone and the frontal bone forming the forehead, and again, some of the occipital bone. Now from this view, we can also see several of the sutures, which are the joints that attach the bones of the skull together. So again, here's the temporal bone and the parietal bone. And this suture here is called the squamous suture. All right, a suture is a type of joint. So here's the squamous suture. And again, rotating towards the front, here we have the frontal bone. And I'm just going to go ahead and take a look at the superior view. Here's the frontal bone. And then here you have a joint called the coronal suture, sort of like a crown. So here's the coronal suture. It joins the frontal bone to the two parietal bones. And then further along, you can see this very midline structure joining the two parietal bones from the right and the left. And this is called the sagittal suture, that connects the two parietal bones. And then rotating it around again to the posterior view, here again you can see the sagittal suture connecting my two parietal bones. And then this is called the lambdoid suture. And the lambdoid suture connects the occipital bone to the two parietal bones on the right and the left. So again, here's the occipital bone and the lambdoid suture. If we look at the inferior view of the skull, so again, here you see the occipital bone, and there's a couple of parts of the occipital bone we can see from the external. One is this very large hole through which the spinal cord enters and exits the brain. This is called the foramen magnum. Foramen means hole, magnum means big. So the foramen magnum, found in the occipital bone. And then these two large protrusions or bumps on either side of the foramen magnum are called the occipital condyles. The occipital condyles serve as a joint between the occipital bone, the skull, and the first cervical vertebrae. And they form a joint that enables the head also to move front and back, like if I was nodding at you. So here you see the occipital condyles. Also from the lateral view, here we have our temporal bone, but you can also see here, sitting right underneath this arch right here, this is called the sphenoid bone. It's actually a bone that crosses over the midline, so you can see the same sphenoid bone, single sphenoid bone, on the other side as well. And we're going to see that also from the internal view, as well as from the orbit of the eye as well. So here's our sphenoid bone.